everybody. It's glad to see you all. Today is Memorial Mass. It's for James Norton. This Mass is extreme. We welcome James and English family and friends across this country. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant James may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw new heavens and a new earth. The former heavens and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no longer. I also saw a new Jerusalem, the holy city, coming down out of heaven from God, beautiful as a bride prepared to meet her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne cry out, "This is God's dwelling among men. He shall dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and he shall be their God, who is always with them. He shall wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, crying out or pain, for the former world has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said to me, "See, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To anyone who thirsts, I will give to drink without cost from the spring of life-giving water. He who wins the victory shall inherit these gifts. I will be his God, and he shall be my son." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Reading from the first letter of John. See what love the Father has bestowed on us in letting us be called children of God. Yet that is what we are. The reason the world does not recognize us is that it never recognized the Son. Dearly beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall later be has not yet come to light. We know that when it comes to light, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in a tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, only about 2 miles away, and many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord. I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who's coming into the world." Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. A reading of the Holy Gospel.
Again, I want to welcome you all to the anniversary Mass for James, and a special welcome to Ingrid, the wife of James, and indeed to all his friends, and a welcome to all his friends scattered about throughout this country and as well Holy Ireland as well. Friends, as I said, a year ago, we came together and we celebrated the life of James. And at that Mass, being very, very recent, of course, of his death, we were open as much as possible to the Lord's gifts. And we prayed for the gifts of the Lord's compassion and the Lord's gift of courage. And because we hope that throughout the year that these gifts were very present to everybody, James's friends, and of course Ingrid, as we grieved together. As well on that day, we celebrated the great gift of new life that James received because of his dying. This was his reward because of his way of life and because too of his acceptance of the Lord in the great sacrament of baptism. So friends, today then, we are thankful for the Lord's great gifts in our lives. And although the year has gone, our memories of James remain. And we remember his many gifts, but two special gifts stand out. And that were his competitive gifts of spirit and fire. These two gifts served James very well. And even though his illness may have killed his body, his illness did not kill his spirit. And that was the power of these two inner strengths that he had, his competitive gifts of fire and spirit. There's many of us admired all these gifts in Jim. And I personally had an experience to experience those competitive gifts one time. We were out playing golf in Great Oxbow Creek Golf Course in a foursome. Now for golfers, that means that there were four people playing and we had two teams. And I happened to be on James's team. Anyway, we went along fine. And unfortunately, I happened to be goofing off a little bit. And I took a shot and the ball ended up in the woods. All of a sudden, James roared at me. And he said, "Are we a team or not?" I said, "Oh yes, we are." And friends, you can imagine, all day long, I did not put another shot into the woods. what a moment. But again, expressing who he really was. Friends, his illness, though it was so dominant in the life of James, it did not define him totally. In Ireland, as a priest, he ministered to many, many people. He was a teacher, ministered to young people as a teacher in a high school in Ireland. And as well, he was a chaplain in the Irish Army as well. In the States, he served as a priest in many, many parishes throughout our diocese. Many speak well of his ministries. And friends, here in Columbus, he was a chaplain, again, to many people. He was a chaplain at St. Francis Hospital, a chaplain as well at Franciscan Woods. And he was a chaplain as well in the Bradley Center, serving people who may have had special needs. Friends, he had that sensitivity He had that gift of reaching out and bringing the Lord's love and mercy and hope to people in all his ministries. And of course, he was a tremendous husband, as we know he was. Speaking with Ingrid, she made sure that we didn't know that here. And as well, that was very much an evidence for us all to know. So friends, today, as we gather, a year behind us, and we are no different as we were that day, in the sense that we celebrate and rejoice knowing that James is now with the Lord. And as well, we are open again as our journey continues, missing James, that we will have still those great gifts of the Lord's courage and the Lord's gift of his compassion as we journey forward each day. Friends, may God bless and be with James in heaven forever, and may he rest in peace. Amen. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. If you stand, please. Sister, lead us again in the prayers of faith. Sister Amy.
For our brother James, as we come together, we ask you to listen to our prayer, confident in your goodness and mercy. For James, who was given the promise of eternal life in baptism, give him communion with the angels and the saints. We pray to the Lord.
The Lord, hear our prayer.
We give thanks to all the hospital and hospice chaplains for their spiritual support to the sick and their families. May God give healing to the sick and support to the staff in their work. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those in the medical professions. Lord, continue to bless their work in caring and healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for family, neighbors, and friends who during this past year continue to show their love, concerns, and support to Ingrid. Lord, give them the rewards of their goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who have died in the hope of rising again, especially James' parents, James and Kathleen Dalton, and his sister Noreen, Ingrid's parents, Willie and Elizabeth Bruning, with all the relatives and friends who have gone before us. Welcome them, Lord, from the light of your presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We ask God in his goodness for healing, justice, and peace in our fractured and divided world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who have gathered here to worship with us in faith. Lord, make us one in your kingdom. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. Again, thanking the Lord as we pray that he is present with us. We pray for our own individual needs as well, whatever they may be. And for our own loved ones who have died, we ask the Lord to be kind and welcome them home as well. And we pray in Mary's name, who brought to us the Lord of compassion and the Lord of strength. We pray, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Please be seated.
Oh,
therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, gave you thanks and praise, took the bread and gave you thanks and praise, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Stephen, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Safe from all distress,
generous sign of peace.
Amen.
Please save us. Thank you, Lord, to you.
song, so I'm going to ask Ingrid to get it and I will let you know. It was a special song that James and Ingrid loved.
Breastplate.
Breastplate of St. Patrick. And she's glad I found out that for you. Do you know? Thank you indeed, Ingrid. So please stand. Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace and glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
The recession ends in
Beautiful.
Oh, you didn't have to look at it.
No, it's not.
Several friends with it. Hang in there, kid.